Hello everyone. Hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end. And also, if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a concept which is known as bank balance sheet versus company's balance sheet. We are going to discuss some of the top 9 differences. So let's begin. See, before we go into the nitty-gritty of the balance sheet of the bank and of the regular company, first we need to look into the nature of each. See, bank basically, it acts as an intermediary between two parties. So the job of the bank is to basically assist to the company, which it can help. So bank makes profits from the thing called spread between the rate it receives and the rate it pays. On the other hand, a company operates to produce goods or services, and it ultimately sells the goods or services to another business. That's the end consumer or to the government. So the objective of running a regular company is to generate and maximize the wealth of the shareholders, right? So as a nature, both of these entities is different. So it makes sense to prepare a unique balance sheet for each of them. Now let's start understanding the bank balance sheet versus company's balance sheet difference with the help of the infographics. The first and the foremost thing that we need to go for is the bank balance sheet is prepared as per the mandate by the regulatory authority. See, regulatory authority over means, you know, about the RBI or as per the SEBI norms and so on and so forth. So over here, it has been prepared by the regulatory authorities. The company balance sheet is prepared as per the regulation of the International Accounting Standard Board. Okay, as per the in India, it is called as the Ind AS. Okay, it is called as the Ind AS, which has now converged from their accounting that was the AS to the Ind AS, which is basically, you know, converging from the Indian standards to the IFRS norms. The rest of the world, they usually follow a thing that's called IFRS, and in US, they follow the US GAAP. So these are the three bifurcation. This is what India follows. This is for the rest of the countries of the world, and this is for USA. So these are the three patterns in which companies basically work with. And for regulatory authority, we are talking about banks, insurance, right? So they have their own norms. So like for banks, you know, RBI is operating, IRDA is operating over here for insurance. And there are companies for which, you know, SEBI also comes into picture. So these are the regulatory authority that comes into picture in terms of India. This was the part of definition. Let's understand the objective. So the main objective is to showcase an accurate trade-off between the bank's profit and the risk. So trade-off between the risk and the profit is the main objective of the bank. But the main objective of the company is to reflect the financial picture of the organization to the stakeholder. The financial picture basically has been disclosed in terms of the income statement, the balance sheet, what we call as the cash flows, the CFS. They have the notes to accounts, and they also have a thing called change in the shareholders equity. So even by that, the disclosures have been made. Post that scenario, if there are any additional documents that are to be issued. So all this material are going to help to depict the perfect financial picture for the companies. And for the banks, it is just, not just, it is accurate trade-off between the bank profit and the risk. Now, what exactly is the scope? Where exactly its horizon stands? The scope of the bank balance sheet is limited since its applicability is only for the banks. It same goes for the insurance. You know, if it's for the insurance, then it will be applicable for the insurance company. But in case of the companies, the scope of the company's balance sheet is much more broader since it is applicable for all sorts of companies, like maybe manufacturing, IT companies, automobiles, pharmaceuticals, and so on and so forth. There are tons of industries in the country. So probably all the norms of the companies will be applied. So the scope is much bigger over here. This is like a specialized thing, and this is more of a customized thing, you know, for every industry. There's a different sort of accounting standard. There's no one sort of accounting standard that will be applicable to one single industry. There will be different sort of accounting standards that will be applicable for different sort of industry, because their operations will differ according to that. The norms and the standards will differ, which should be more appropriate, right? So this is about the scope in the or we can call the horizons in which it stands. The next is the equation. Assets is equal to the liabilities plus shareholders' equity. the bank's assets and liabilities are much different than that of the regular company. So what exactly we are talking about here is the assets. Over here, it's the liability, sorry. And on this side, there is assets, right? Let's say just write serial number. This is how the balance sheet is basically performed. You know, this is how it is actually been disclosed. The serial number over here, let's write amount over here. And on this hand, there is a data for shareholders' equity. And below that, there is a detail of non-current liability and current liability. So this gives our total right here. XXX, you can just write, right? And over here, there are non-current assets, which includes your tangible assets. And there is a non-current liability, which gives our total. And over here, XXX. Right, so assets is equal to your liabilities plus shareholders' equity. As we saw on the liability side, we have shareholders' equity plus liability. And over here, assets is equal to liabilities plus shareholders' equity. But here, assets and liability are much more different because deposits and withdrawals and other line items that have been included, and which is actually different from what the companies have to disclose. Now, what is the level of the complexity? See, preparation of the balance sheet for bank is quite complex since the bank needs to calculate the net loans, and it's a really a tiring task to do that. Well, it involves a lot of amount of the complexity over here, but in case of the companies, it's much simpler because you just need to comply with the norms, how things have to be worked upon. But here, there are much more compliances that you need to be followed and so as to disclose a fair view of the financial statement. Now, what is the time consumption? The bank balance sheet needs a lot of time to prepare, but the company's balance sheet does not take a lot of time to prepare. As because of the complexity, the time consumption is more. Because of the simplicity, the time consumption is less. Now, what are the key concepts? Loans, short-term investments. See, loans are they are the bread and butter for the banks. Short-term investments, with the help of the amount of deposits, they either give loans or whatever deposits they receive, they make loans or either they make investments, allowance for the losses of loans. Over here, assets, liability, and the shareholder's equity are the three main important thing in case of companies. Now, what are the mentionable documents? Bank balance sheet mentions reference to the schedules. Right, there are different schedules in that, and company's balance sheet mentions its reference via its notes to accounts. Right, so here the details have been mentioned into the notes to accounts. As I've recently told you that, you know, there is a notes to accounts section in the company's data. As you can see, income statement, balance sheet, CFS, notes to accounts, changes to shareholders equity, and the documents. So there are details that needs to be complied in the notes to accounts. Well, in banks it is schedules. It's just a change of name. What are the type of the balances? In bank balance sheet, the type of the balance is average. And here it is the ending balance. Ending balance means that the balance that are as on the 31st March 2018 or 2019, whatever may be the scenario, or if it is a calendar year, then 31st of December 2018 or 2019. So ending balance. And over here, the average is taken. So this is the difference between the bank balance sheet and the company's balance sheet. So finally, let me conclude on this. If you look at the balance sheet of the regular company, you will have a surface level of idea about how a balance sheet works. The balance sheet of the bank is arranged in a similar manner, but the items under the heads are different. Moreover, you know, bank use the, as we just saw, average balances for the balance sheet, which is quite unique. But if you compare it with the regular company's operation, even if the balance sheets are quite different in scope, the objective of both of them is quite similar, right? That is to disclose the accurate picture of the financial affairs of the organization.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.